Do you experience some pain here, the top of your buttocks area, or perhaps pain in your groin or your thighs? And what about at night? Do you have to sleep with a pillow between your knees to make it more comfortable? Well, if the answer to these questions is yes, then you're probably struggling with an SI joint pain, a sacroiliac joint pain. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate some really effective exercises for you how to get rid of that pain. Okay, let's get started. So just to help you understand what it is exactly that we're doing, this is an anatomical model of your spine. The lower back sits here, your buttocks sit here. This big bone is called the iliac bone, your pelvis, the iliac bone. This triangular bone is called your sacrum, and the SI joint, sacroiliac joint, is a joint between the sacrum and the iliac. So we're talking about this joint here. And that's the joint that can give you the pain, the top of your buttocks, give you radiating pain in your groin and a pain in your thigh as well. So these exercises here will A, mobilize this joint, and B, I'm helping you to stabilize the joint as well. As with any exercise regime, the devil is always in the detail. So the first exercise I'm going to show you is how to get some more movement in the SI joint. And what you need to do is lay on your back, pull one leg towards your chest as far as you can. And the next bit is important. Really make sure with the other leg that your leg doesn't come up, but you really push your knee into the bench. And that's how you create maximum torsion in the SI joint. So you hold this position for about 10 seconds and then you go to the other side. And repeat this about 3 times and do this about once a day. Okay, so this is exercise 2 and this will really help to stabilize that SI joint. Now, as per usual, devil is in the detail. So what we're going to do is a normal squat, but with a little bit of a kick, we need to place our feet facing outwards. And when we place the feet facing outwards, it's called external rotation. What we're actually doing is we're activating the glute maximus, the muscle at the back here, and the piriformis as well. And by activating them, we are stabilizing our joint a bit more. So feet outwards, and all you do is you come all the way down and up. But when you go to the top, make sure you squeeze your buttocks. So you push your belly a little bit forward. So you really activate those glutes. Come down and up and activate the glutes. And down and up and activate those glutes at the top. Do about 10 repetitions, 3 sets every day. Now, if you want to make this a little bit more difficult, all you need to do is add a TheraBand. So you step into the TheraBand. Same thing here, feet moving out, band over the knees, and then again, come down and up and squeeze those glutes at the top. Down and up and squeeze the glutes at the top. Same thing here, 10 repetitions, 3 sets daily. So in this third exercise, we're stepping the squat up a little grade. Again, what you need to do, have a TheraBand as well. Place this around your knees, get into a squat position, and importantly, make sure your toes, your feet are facing outwards. And all we're going to do now is we're going to walk side to side. So side to side here, side to side to the other side. And this is going to really burn your thighs and your glutes. So sit low. Make sure you don't bend your back too much. Nice and upright. Sit low. Make sure your feet are facing outwards and just walk side to side. And that's definitely going to burn those glutes, the piriformis, your quads as well. And that will help to stabilize that SI joint again. So if you want to stabilize the SI joint, you obviously cannot miss out on this classic exercise, the glute bridge. What you need to do is find yourself a sofa or a bench or something you can stabilize your shoulders on. Make sure that your legs are on the same line as your body, 90 degree angle in the knees. And all you do now is you drop your bottom towards the floor and you raise your bottom back up again. But importantly, at the top of the range, really make sure you squeeze those buttocks and also have your feet again facing outwards. So come down to the floor, all the way up, squeeze your buttocks at the top, and then hold this for a few seconds, repeat 10 times and do 3 sets and do this daily. Now, one muscle you must stretch if the SI joint is giving you a problem is the piriformis muscle. And there are 2 ways of doing this. Let me demonstrate it to you. So I'm going to straighten out, to stretch out my right piriformis muscle. So I need to lay on my back. I've got my left leg bent. I'm going to place my right ankle on my left knee and we're going to pull my left knee now towards my chest. And I should feel this around there. Hold this for about 10 seconds and repeat 3 to 5 times and do this daily. Yeah. And for the other side, obviously bend the right leg, left ankle on the right knee, pull this knee towards me and hold this again for about 10 seconds and repeat 3 to 5 times and do this daily. This is one way of doing it. Now, sometimes people actually don't feel it when they do it this way. So the other way to do it is, again, I'm going to stretch out my right piriformis muscle, straighten my left leg, place my right foot on the outside of my left knee. I'm going to pull my right knee towards my left chest. I'm going to rotate my body towards the involved side as far as I can, keeping nice and upright. And again, I should feel that around this area, deep in your buttock area. Hold this again for about 10 seconds and repeat 3 to 5 times. Yeah? And the other side, obviously, left foot on the outside of the right knee, pull my left knee towards me and rotate my body the other way. And again, 10 seconds, 3 to 5 times daily. So sacroiliac joint instability is very common in women who either are pregnant or have just given birth to the child. And reason for that is that during the last trimester of your pregnancy, the ligaments are all being made weak in the body to prepare the body to actually give birth. So for those patients, what I do in conjunction with the exercises that I have demonstrated to you is I advise them to wear a trochanteric belt or a pelvic belt as well. And what you need to do is you need to find, there's a bony bit here around this area here on your side of your hip. There's a little gap on top of that. You place 2 fingers on top of the gap and that's where the belt needs to sit. So what you do is you place the belt around your pelvis. There we are. 2 fingers above that gap is where it needs to sit. And in this case, we've got some elastic bands here. We're going to pull them out. Now, this is important. Squeeze your glutes, squeeze your buttocks. It helps to stabilize the joint a bit more. Come to the side, come forward. And this is how you stabilize your SI joints as well. Now, you can actually use this belt as well with those exercises. So if those exercises are quite painful to do, then stabilize your pelvis a bit more with this belt. I hope you found a lot of value in this video. If you did, please don't hesitate and just leave me a comment, subscribe, give me a thumbs up. It is super motivating for me to see if people appreciate the videos I put out there. So for me, that's it for now. I say take care of yourself, take care of someone else as well if you can, and bye for now. Bye-bye.